On this week's episode, we speak about the delivery and supply chain demand that Peloton are experiencing.
And I get to talk to Julia Katharina of the German Ladies Facebook community and much, much more.
Welcome to Pelo Buddy TV, your unofficial resource for everything Peloton, by the community, for the community. Here are your hosts, Mark O'Rourke in the UK and Amanda Siegel in the US.
Welcome to episode 12 of Pelo Buddy TV, a show by the Peloton community for the Peloton community. I'm Amanda Siegel and I'm joined by my co-host Mark O'Rourke. Hi Mark, you there?
Hi Amanda. Yeah, I know I'm in a slightly new setting for this episode. I've moved to another room and the light is much better in this room. So yeah, I'm quite excited. Slightly different.
I like it, Mark.
One.
I do. I like it. And I love that amazing Pedal Buddy sign you have there behind you. I need to get with the program. I think we need to have a chat with your buddy up there, Carl Bowes, right?
That's
and,
right.
And I need to figure out how I get one of those behind me. I think it would be perfect up there, right
well,
above my
we'll
head.
We'll sort something out, Amanda, I'm sure.
We need to work on that. I got a rep, absolutely. Tell me, Mark, did you have a good week?
Yeah, great week. Lots going on as normal. And yesterday I jumped on this crazy 900th ride with somebody I know. Who was that person? Oh, it was you.
It was me, Mark. It was, oh my goodness. It was fantastic. It was absolutely fantastic. So I did, Leanne Hainsby's, she did a funk ride, in honor of UK Black History Month. The music was amazing. I wasn't sure what to expect. I really wasn't sure what to expect, but the music was amazing. And, it was truly a fantastic ride. And, you know, I'll say it again. You know, folks have been saying to me, how did you get there so quickly? You're at 900 again. And, you know, I've mentioned it on the show before and I'll say it again, Mark. I am absolutely emphatic now about doing warm up and cool down rides. And I think they have made such a difference to my strength and to my output. As everybody knows, I've been a little disappointed with my own output on the rides recently, having switched over to the Bike Plus, as the resistance is so much harder. And I was really frustrated initially, but I have to tell you, I've been working really hard. And last week I was definitely in a funk, but I got on the bike last weekend and hit about 3 personal bests. And then this week, you know, again, was adding those into my rides, and I had hashtag road to 900 the whole week as I finally got there. And Mark, I gotta tell you, it makes a big difference doing those rides. So yeah, people can call them stacking, whatever. They're on there for a reason, right?
Amanda, you got a great shout out by Leanne. It was epic. And yeah, I mean, listen, I think it was great to ride with so many people and for you on there. And I think I high-fived you about 3,000 times, if memory serves me correct.
I love my high-fives. Are you kidding? I love my high-fives. Maybe, yeah, I was pushing for a PB, which I got. Right. But yeah. You know what? It's amazing. The community is amazing. There were so many people that had jumped on. And, there's no question that it just makes for a fun experience and just pushes you harder. So from that perspective, I have to say thank you to all those. I know some of my Pelo friends are Pelo Buddy viewers, and I really, really appreciate you guys having jumped on, really from the bottom of my heart, thank you. So on to 1,000. Can you imagine what the celebration's gonna be then, Mark? I mean, we're gonna be popping champagne.
It's gonna be a lot of fun, that's for sure.
I'm telling you. Well, Mark, before we get started with the news, we always like to let you know how you can keep up to date with all our content across all of our platforms. Every episode, as well as breaking news items, are released on our YouTube channel. Just hit the subscribe button at the bottom right-hand side of the video and hit the notify button to make sure you never miss an episode.
Not forgetting the podcast as well, Amanda. This week I was listening back to one or two episodes as I was driving on a long journey. And you know what? You pick up so much more on the podcast when you're having to listen and focus more rather than watch on a video. I mean, both are great, but I'm really enjoying the podcast. So if you've not watched, listened to one of the podcasts, then yeah, we're all on all the major platforms, Amanda.
Yeah, I think the podcasts are fantastic. And as you say, it gives you an opportunity to just really focus. Here you get distracted by our fantastic good looks. So, you know, when they're listening on the podcast, they don't get that, right, Mark? And finally, we are on Facebook and Instagram. Just search for Pelo Buddy and like, follow us on all those platforms for all of the latest news. And Mark, let's get on with the show.
First, let's do a rundown of the latest Pelo news.
We had yet another very busy week with all things Peloton. We saw some very unhappy folks in the Peloton community. This past week, as suppliers just can't meet the demand. As we are all fully aware, since March and the beginning of the COVID-19 pandemic, the Peloton has seen an unprecedented and unexpected surge in orders. At one point, John Foley, our CEO, stated in an interview that their order numbers in early spring were more in line with what they would normally see for a holiday season. The difference, though, with the holiday season surge is that it is expected, and the company scales up both production and staff to deal with those months in advance, which clearly wasn't possible here, Mark. This week, Peloton had actually added a banner to their website notifying customers that bike delivery times were about 4 to 9 weeks, and Bike Plus was just released that it exceeds 12 weeks. So for folks that are anxious to get on this Peloton bandwagon, certainly through the pandemic, and all the hype about the new Bike Plus and the upgrades that the new Bike Plus have, I think folks are really, really, frustrated. Unfortunately, what has compounded this issue is that some of Peloton's inventory seems to be caught up in shipping due to the congestion at the Los Angeles port. Unfortunately, Mark, the delay of shipping has also contributed to Peloton's stock ratings as well. Goldman Sachs downgraded Peloton to neutral from buy. They do still believe in the long-term opportunity, though, so I wouldn't have anyone start selling their newly purchased stock quite yet. If I remember correctly, a friend of mine and co-host went ahead and bought some stock recently. I certainly would not think that it's going to ultimately impact it long-term. I think it's frustrated and people are frustrated. And when these type of things happen, we do see a drop in stock. But I have faith that it will rise back up. And I guess we will have to see what happens in the upcoming Q1 2021 earnings call in a few weeks. I believe you have some info on that, Mark.
I do indeed, Amanda. Yes. So Peloton have announced the first quarter fiscal 2021 earnings release date, a conference call and webcast. Yeah. Peloton will release its first quarter fiscal 2021 results after the US stock market closes on Thursday, November the 5th. The company will also hold a conference to discuss the results at 5 p.m. Eastern time that day. It's going to be really interesting to see what they have to say, Amanda. Yeah, I think it's, what you were saying earlier about the delays on shipments and what have you, will it affect their earnings?
Right. I mean, yeah, and I'm curious to see what John Foley has to say. I mean, you know, you can be apologetic. I think people have to be understanding. Look, we're a premier product. There is no question that Peloton is a premier product. I hope people aren't foolish and look elsewhere just because there is this delay. So I think it's something that we will listen to very carefully and see what the word on the street's going to be once those Q1 earning estimates come out. One thing I will say, though, Mark, is that Peloton certainly know how to take care of their employees. With the upcoming US election, they have announced that they will be closing the New York City studio on Tuesday, November the 3rd. For all live classes, and all staff will have the day off to go vote, which I think really shows that they care about their staff and they want to make sure that everybody is prepared. With that being said, the London studio, I do believe, will be open. I only see one class on the schedule for right now. Leanne does have her early morning Tuesday class, which wouldn't impact the US anyway, because it's a UK timed class as far as morning goes. But folks could jump on that if they wanted a fresh new class later on in the day in the US. But as far as new classes, staff, etc., they are shutting down. So there'll be one day. It's an interesting time here in the States right now, Mark. We're all waiting with bated breath to see what will happen. But I appreciate that Peloton are in fact looking out for their staff.
Yeah, well, you're right, Amanda. I mean, the election in the USA is going to be such an important event, not just in the US, but around the world. Clearly, America are one of the most powerful countries in the world. And so, I'm going to be watching with real interest, and we'll probably stay up to early hours. And it's going to be very, very interesting to see how it all pans out, Amanda. Yeah, in other news, Peloton have announced a German partnership with the DFB Academy, the German Football Academy. Peloton said that they have a strong partner through the collaboration of the DFB Academy, the German Football Academy. Together, they will develop innovative training concepts and will advance fitness innovation. Oliver Bierhoff, director of the German national team and the DFB Academy, owns a Peloton bike, Amanda, and he's very excited about the up-and-coming partnership. He went on to say, "We are very proud to have gained with Peloton a dynamically growing partner for our DFB Academy. So I believe it's going to be a mix of workout disciplines like cardio and strength, stretching and yoga, designed to support the daily training of the footballers." By the way, Amanda, the first two classes drop this coming week, and it's going to be interesting. Now, on PeloChats this week, we have a fantastic lady called Jules, who founded the Peloton Ladies German Facebook group. And she's on talking about lots of things. But one of the subjects she talks about is this partnership. So a little bit more information coming up from Jules later, Amanda.
That's fantastic. Yeah, I'm so thrilled, Mark, that we've incorporated the German community into our Pelo Buddy TV show. They're a vital part of the, you know, international perspective of, the platform. And it's been really great. And I have done some reading up on Jules, and she looks fantastic. You've got the privilege of getting to interview her. I can't wait to hear it. And we'll certainly stay tuned to make sure that I get to hear that and what she has to say. As far as that goes. Mark, so there have also been tons of class updates this past week. Peloton announced a series of Halloween classes, with Halloween coming up at the end of the week. To see the full list of what's on the agenda, of course, head over to PeloBuddy.com. We make sure that we report everything, and all the classes are up there. They're just too many to announce here on the show, but definitely go and take a look at what classes are on there. I do know that they have incorporated runs, rides, yoga flows, and I even believe there's going to be a Halloween boot camp and strength class thrown in, Mark. If it's anything like last year, where Emma Lovewell rode as Princess Leia from Star Wars, I believe Matt Wolpers did an entire class in the style of Cody Rigsby, and Olivia D'Amato ran as Wonder Woman, and many, many other costumes. We're in for a treat this year. I'm sure that they are going to go above and beyond on those classes. So I'm looking really, really forward to that. You know, Mark, I was so fortunate. I was actually in London last year for Halloween and got to ride in studio with Leanne. While she didn't dress up the members did. And it was so, so fun to be in the studio. I believe it was my 300th ride. Is that crazy? Just a year ago, it was my 300th ride. I was in London on business, and I had booked to ride in studio. And as you know, your UK community are just fantastic. So the members came dressed up, a lot of face masks, you know, just fun costumes, and were totally, totally in it. So while the picture's there for you guys to see, we all got together in a lovely group photo shot. Of course, I didn't even think to have a costume, and I don't know if I would have. But I was front and center in that, Brian. I was making sure that I was right there in front of that camera. But it was tons of fun. So, with that being said, I really do miss those studio rides, Mark. I'm telling you, there was something so special. And I'm just hoping, fingers crossed, that we get to ride back in the studio shortly. I really hope that.
Shouldn't be too long, Amanda. And are you going to dress up this year for Halloween?
I don't know, Mark. It'll be in my gym, so I can do it for myself, right? Maybe that should be fun. Well, Mark, there were, as I said, there were just tons of announcements this week as far as what's going on the platform. Some other updates are that Jess King's experience has been announced for season 2. So that should be a ton of fun. And I know that the Jess King followers are thrilled. I've seen stuff on social media. They are so thrilled that is going to be something that she is putting out there. There are also some more bar classes that are coming. Those will be launched in 2021. And lastly, we have that they've added a Train Smart Meditation collection, which in turn actually removed the 10 strength classes originally launched. The new Train Smart Meditation Collection has the same stated goal as before, curated classes to give you the most effective training and get the most out of your workouts. So that's going to be really cool to see. They have actually removed the 10 strength classes that they had under that Train Smart, and now we'll have the yoga classes out there. And lastly, a new artist series was announced for this upcoming week so far. The artist is Emeli Sande, and Hannah Frankson will be doing a ride on Tuesday. So tons of new things on the platform, Mark, and it's going to be fun to jump on all of those for the week.
Yeah, loads going on. The next piece of news is a bit of a strange story that came across Pelo Buddy's desk this week. And I don't know if you're even aware of this, Amanda, but Peloton are in legal trademark dispute with a beverage company called the Peloton Cold Brew LLC. Peloton, the bike company, is requesting the trademark to be invalidated on two separate grounds: priority and likelihood of confusion, as well as abandonment. Amanda, although the Peloton Cold Brew doesn't appear to be specifically selling coffee at the time of publishing, the current products have been available. And one of the products is called Peloton Tuscara Tea. Tuscara is made from the outer skin of coffee beans, so their product appears to be confusing both tea and coffee. Anyway, it's not clear how the patent office would interpret that. In terms of it keeping in their trademark still active, Peloton Cold Brew sounds like they intend to fight this in court, and they've set up a GoFundMe for legal fees. Peloton Cold Brew made an official announcement, Amanda, saying, "My brother Dave and I started Peloton Cold Brew in early 2015. We've built an incredible brand that sells beverages up and down the East Coast and Texas. We have family and friends' money invested in the company over years of hard work and dedication. Never once did Peloton reach out and say anything to us. Five years later, they're now threatening to sue us, bullying us into getting rid of our registered trademark for beverages made of coffee. They're a multi-billion dollar company and can bankrupt us. Peloton Cold Brew have until November the 17th, 2020, to respond to the initial court complaint." So quite a bizarre story there, Amanda.
I had no idea. I've never heard of it. I am not a huge coffee drinker. I am a tea drinker, although you said they kind of go between coffee and tea, so who knows? Interesting. We'll have to kind of watch that and see what happens. Look, for Peloton, I guess they could probably just buy them out. Who knows? Yeah.
Peloton, listen, Peloton are a huge, huge company now. And listen, one thing's for sure, their trademark, the Peloton trademark and everything else that goes with it is so critical to the success of that company. And I think anything that goes against that or comes across that, then they have to fight it. So be interesting to see how it pans out in due time.
Yeah.
Well, I'm sure we'll do an update in the next few weeks and months to come.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to actually hearing what happens with that. That should be interesting. Certainly, Mark Peloton's new head of marketing, Dara Treseder, will have something to say about that. And certainly from a marketing perspective, it should be interesting. So with that being said, Dara was actually recently interviewed by LinkedIn this past week. As we very clearly remember Peloton's ad campaign last year, Mark, which had been widely criticized for its Peloton wife ad, Treseder has helped launch its new campaign, We All Have Our Reasons, which is focused on spotlighting the community. Treseder calls the community one of the most valuable elements of the brand and chose to move away from its previous marketing that focused on its products and services. She goes on to say that the new We All Have Our Reasons campaign is one of the most proud moments of her career. So I think, Mark, what she has done in the short time that she's been with Peloton has absolutely turned things around. Her interview was amazing, and of course you can find it on PeloBuddy.com. But she seems to be an incredibly dynamic woman. I'm looking to see for amazing things coming out of the marketing aspect of the of the product, because she is a wealth of information. She comes from an incredible background. The interview was amazing, and I do love the fact that she's incorporated the community. The ads have been amazing. I do have to laugh though. My 85-year-old father said to me yesterday, we were together, and he said to me, Amanda, why aren't you on that new Peloton ad? And I had such a good laugh. I'm like, Dad,
Amanda,
I'm asking the same damn question, right, Mom? I mean, why weren't we picked up? Maybe we're just too basic. Because I have to say,
future adverts, Amanda. Come on.
I'm telling you, but you know what, Mark? What Dara has done in utilizing the community and the members has been fantastic. They, we focused on it a little bit last week, and we incorporated that in our news. And I really have paid attention and actually started following some of the members. In fact, Wunder Woman, the German woman that was focused on the ad, liked me and followed me on Instagram, and we've been following each other, and she's
Wunder
fantastic.
Wunder Mama, I think she goes.
Wunder Mama, is that what it is? Yeah. That's sorry, I couldn't remember. So that was really, that's been really fun. And I think, it brings a different dynamic, because we are Peloton, right? I mean, there is no question that the community is what has driven Peloton to truly incorporate everybody from all aspects. So, Dara's interview
funny
was...
You mention her, because, again, she was mentioned on the Pelo Chats, and Jules talks about Wunder Mama. So, I love how there's an interaction going on during the news and the Pelo Chats for this week, Amanda. It's great.
Yeah, that's amazing. Yeah. Well, I think that's important. I mean, it's nice to be able to get folks from the community on the chats that can give us some insight into what's going on there.
Yeah. So, Amanda, you may recall a couple of episodes ago, we covered a story about Peloton being entered into the 2020 AFP Pinnacle Award Grand Prize for Excellence in Treasury and Finance. Well, unfortunately, they lost to Dreja. The runners-up for the Pinnacle Award were Alphabet, Google's parent company, and Peloton. So you can't win them all, Amanda, but it was a big thing to be entered into such a formidable group of international companies. And can't win them all, Amanda, but they did well to get there in the first place, I think.
Right. And we have to remember, you know, that Peloton is only just a few years old. I mean, it has so much time to grow and have an opportunity down the road to claim those prestigious awards. So, I mean, absolutely wonderful that they were even nominated and had their name up there. And then, Mark, of course, this past week saw another merch drop. Actually, I think it was probably the week just before last, because I am wearing one of the new merch drop pieces of clothing. Didn't go quite as crazy this time as I did with the previous merch drop, but there is no question that they are very much on their game now in trying to make sure that merchandise is being dropped more frequently and that they have more stock. Unfortunately, some of the really good things do just go so fast. But I am very resourceful, Mark, and I have actually discovered, I shouldn't be giving my secrets away, but I have discovered that for some reason, folks in the US are way more of the shopaholic mind frame than those in Germany and in the UK. And I actually found there was one of the outfits from the new merch drop that I loved, and it just went so fast and I wasn't able to buy it, that it was on the German website, on the German apparel. And I have a dear friend of mine that's actually living in Germany at the moment. And I messaged her and said, if I purchase something on the German website and have it sent to you, do you think you can mail it to me? I did it. So I'm really excited. In fact, you know what it was, Mark? It was the outfit that Leanne wore in her ride on Friday. And I was so bummed, especially when I saw she looked so gorgeous in it. And I was like, damn, I want that outfit. So it's coming.
Amanda, your persistence is incredible when it comes to merchandise.
When it comes to Peloton, I mean, it's crazy. It's just, it's a joke. But you know what? Today with the pandemic, I never go out, Mark. So if all I'm wearing are my Peloton gear, you know, and I'm not having to dress up, I'm more than happy. I thought that was a fun story to share.
Amanda, we have lots of instructors in the news for this week's episode. First of all, Ali Love, who announced in Women's Health that she had almost died in a car accident when she was 9 years of age. She was hit by a car and broke her left femur. Ali was in hospital for 7 days, and after about 4 or 5 days, it wasn't looking very good because she was losing a lot of blood. I couldn't have surgery, Ali explained, right away, because the pin that the doctors needed had to be specially made in China and shipped over. Usually, lived in old people who break their hip, so it took quite a few days. Meanwhile, I was lying in bed with a weight at the end of my ankle, separating my bone so that it wouldn't heal. The doctor told my mom that she might not see her again. She came into the room and told me I had two choices. You can either choose to let go or go and be with God, or you can choose to pray and fight for your life. The doctor even told her she would never run again. Well, after 1 year of physio, Ali did recover, Amanda, and go on to be the famous Peloton instructor we know her for. What an amazing story.
Amazing, Mark. I mean, I have been fortunate enough to hear her speak about it on some of her rides. And I have to say, you know, it's amazing that these instructors are just as forthcoming with these type of stories that they are, because truthfully, it gives people hope. You know, there could be somebody that could be in a similar situation or could have a family member in a similar situation, and them being so open and honest in sharing this experience. And I think that gives us, you know, understanding as to her deep, deep belief in her religion and in God. And I admire her for that. And, you know, so I've seen some folks say she's a little bit preachy on her rides, but you know what, for me, and look, I'm not the same faith that she is. I get on those rides, and, you know, I've always said that she instills something in me. I'm not a religious person, but boy, oh boy, when I sat in some of those rides, I am so proud to be part of the, you know, the religion of Peloton and Ali Love. So really,
Ali's great, Amanda, and I think it's great to see the personal sides of these instructors, their personal faiths that come up. There's no harm to be told about it, or to be said or explained about one's faith. And I think she's great. She's inspirational. And I love Ali. So the second bit of news is about Hannah Corbin, who announced an InStyle exclusive lower body workout, which is designed to burn in the best possible way. The bar, inspired by ballet, Pilates and yoga, focuses on tiny movements. It's low impact, and bar is also the preferred cross-training workout for many avid runners and cyclists. That's why Peloton decided to launch the bar program last month, which consists of 10 workouts ranging from 5 to 10 minutes. Amanda, have you done any of these bar exercise any rides yet or not?
Yeah, no, I'm glad you brought it up. No, I haven't. And I have to say, I think Hannah's fantastic. And I have done her foam rolling series. She did an amazing with the foam rolling series, and every now and again when I'm really tight and sore, I've done that, and it's really, really helped. I think that is something I don't find enough time to get to do everything. Peloton are giving us too much. It's just hard to really find time for everything. But that is important, and I would definitely love to be able to try that. I'm not making any challenges. I think our last one we may have we did well on
the yoga challenge failed. Miserably, didn't it?
I know. It's just, I'm not ready yet. The strength one we did. So that one, I have to say, we both did. We did great.
We did.
The yoga one we'll get to eventually, but the bar, I think, is something that I would personally like to try. Do guys do it? Is bar for guys too? I'm not sure. Maybe. You'll have to try it and tell us.
Maybe.
Yeah, tell
maybe,
us what else.
Maybe not. So the third instructor news item, Amanda, is around Jess King. Jess told Sweat Life podcast how she found her start in fitness at a very young age, what she loves about being a beginner, and how she took the initiative to becoming a tread instructor in training at Peloton. What the Peloton team did for her to help her succeed, plus a super personal family goal she shared about her new fiancé, Sophia Arista. And we touched on this on that subject a couple of episodes ago, I think, Amanda.
We did. She is. She's recently engaged, and we're looking forward to that. And again, you know, saying this again, it's so lovely that that they put themselves out there and they share. I mean, they're celebrities. Ultimately, they are. There are celebrities, but it's wonderful to hear what they're doing out there each week. So, yes, fantastic.
Finally, Amanda, Emma Lovewell told the Thrive Global Digital Magazine in a 5-part video series, How I Work. It was in conjunction with Salesforce. Thrive Global explore the ways that different leaders and creators are adapting the way that they work during COVID-19 and using technology to navigate challenges and plan for the future. Emma explained on a video how her morning routine fuels her work throughout the day. And it was really interesting to watch. I love these videos, Amanda. I don't know if you've had a chance to see them or not.
So yes, Mark, it actually was Emma Lovewell's birthday this past week. And I would like to share that our fantastic Chris Lewis celebrated a birthday this weekend too. Chris, happy, happy birthday. If it wasn't for you, we wouldn't have this absolutely amazing show and get to share all of this with you guys watching and listening. So to Chris Lewis, a very happy birthday. And Chris, Mark, shares a birthday with Matt Wilpers. Matt got to celebrate his birthday this weekend as well. So some fantastic birthdays. And as everybody knows, I love birthdays. So any opportunity to celebrate anybody is fantastic. So Chris Lewis, Emma, Matt, hope you guys all had a fantastic
birthday. Chris Lewis is in good company, Amanda, isn't he? Same birthday as Matt Wilpers.
Let's get to know another person behind the leaderboard name in Pelo Chats.
I'm really happy to introduce a lady called Jules Katharina, who's from Germany, lives in the UK. And Jules, are you there?
Hi, Mark. Yes, I'm here. Great to meet you. Thanks so much for having me today.
Great to have you with us, Jules. And I know that you set up the German Ladies Peloton Group, I don't know how long ago, maybe you can tell us. But first of all, maybe tell us a little bit about yourself.
Yeah, so I'm Jules _ Katharina on the leaderboard. I actually received my Peloton, I think it was back in May. It was one of those lockdown purchases, but very, very happy I took the step. And yeah, I basically, like, when I placed the order, it obviously took, I think, 4 or 5 weeks to get the bike. I was already kind of, I loved how the German community was kind of interacting with each other. There were so many great women that I decided, even before I received the bike, to start opening up a German ladies group, just to connect, kind of have a bit more of an intimate feel rather than obviously posting in the official German group. But yeah, been a Peloton member ever since, and absolutely love having my bike. Like, it's been absolute lifesaver during lockdown and obviously the world we're in.
Yeah, yeah. See, we knew, I think you may know or may not know, but I set up Peloton UK Community. We're almost at our 2-year second anniversary in about 2 weeks' time, I think it is. And at the time, I was one of the first people to, my wife and I were the first people to get the bike in the UK, and we were really excited, and we'd seen it over in the States and it come to the UK. And then of course a few months later, or maybe 12, I don't when did it actually arrive in Germany, Peloton? Do you remember?
It was
when?
November 2019.
So it's coming up to about a year, isn't it?
Yeah, it's coming up to a year.
Yeah, so a year after it launched in the UK, it launched in Germany. I remember talking to Kevin Cornils, who's the MD of Global Peloton, and who's based down in London, and he was talking about the German, setting up the German community and the German, or launching Peloton in Germany rather. And and I wondered then, you know, there's going to be some German Facebook groups, and of course your group is one of the first groups. And how many members do you have now in the ladies group?
I think it's just under 500. Yeah, so it's still quite, I'd say we're in the early stages. We're not quite at Peloton women's page, or, you know, the UK equivalent, like, of the ladies page. But it's a very active community, and I'm also super thankful. I have two other admins, Ina and Claudia, who you might sometimes see commenting on your Pelo Buddy TV channel, and they're helping me run the community. So we also have an Instagram account. We're having obviously tribe rides that we organize, and lots of other events that are going on. So some of the ones you featured, we've been secretly behind them, like Oktoberfest and drinking well in the Peloton.
Yeah.
Don't know if I should have a disclaimer here. Don't do that.
No, exactly. So you've got a thriving community, and I mean, at Pelo Buddy TV, we're following the German community, and we're trying to get you guys involved. And I know that you had some communication with Chris Giles, our producer, recently, and this is why you're on the show today. And it's great to have you. And yeah, so I mean, how's it going in Germany? I mean, what's the do you know any numbers or any official numbers of how many people have bought the bike, or?
I mean, all I can say is, I guess Peloton's always quite secretive about how many bikes they actually sold. But I think a good indicator is that obviously the delivery time, and the Bike Plus at the moment has a delivery time of, I don't know, I think if you're ordering now, you're looking at about a January or February delivery, which is kind of on par with the UK. So it has been growing a lot. I mean, you do see what we've noticed a lot as well in Germany. They've really upped their marketing game. So you're seeing a lot of online advertising in German, for Peloton, so it does look like they're growing quite a lot, and obviously we can tell by just the numbers of new members that we received. I think mostly during the last push, so ever since the Bike Plus has come out and obviously they've increased their marketing, we've definitely seen a huge influx of members, not just for the ladies, but I think in the official German group as well.
No, it's very exciting what's happening. Guy was I was in the Peloton shop in Birmingham this morning, looking at the Bike Plus. I've looked at it twice now, Jules. I haven't ordered it yet, because I quite like the original. It does everything for me. And at some point I might put my foot in the water and go and buy one. But at the moment I'm happy with the original bike. And but yeah, I mean, it's exciting what's going on in Germany, and I watch with interest, and I think there's possibly going to be some more European countries coming into the Peloton umbrella at some point in the future. And so you obviously come across Pelo Buddy TV, and what are your thoughts on Pelo Buddy TV? Because you were telling us you've been watching a few episodes.
I love it. I think it's obviously the TV show itself, but also just your social media channels. Like, it's really where we sometimes get our insights from. And like, we may or may not have been sometimes discussing some of your news in our ladies group as well. Just because it's stuff that, you know, if you're just reading Peloton official news, I don't think we would have come across quite a few of the points you've pointed out recently.
Well, PeloBuddy.com, obviously Chris Lewis runs that over in, he's based over in Georgia, Atlanta, Georgia. And we base all our news pieces on PeloBuddy.com, and we're always excited to see all the news coming up. We've got some great news stories coming up in this episode. But yeah, just going back to the German community and Peloton over there, we touched on a news story recently about the new instructor and Cliff Dewenger. Do you have any updates on that, or anything, any new news or anything you're picking up, Jules?
That's a good question. I mean, again, Peloton has obviously been quite quiet about it. We have, ever since you guys talked about it, we've also been kind of keeping an eye on social media if to see if there's anything we can pick up. I think our guesses are in terms of the community is, I think it's going to be probably quite a lot hip-hop heavy, rap heavy, because so Cliff's background, I don't know if you guys knew this, he was actually a participant in The Voice of Germany.
Yeah.
And when you look at like some of the, like his, he was very much focused on kind of rap hip-hop. And it is something that when you actually look at the German classes in Peloton, like it is not very prominent. So obviously on the English class, you do have a lot of hip hop rides. It's not something that Eric or Irene have done a lot, I'd say. So we do think that there may be a possibility that a lot more hip hop rap kind of theme rides come in. But equally, I think we're so excited to actually have someone like just new joining it, someone with TV exposures. I think what we can see from like the Voice of Germany appearance of Cliff, like he seemed like a really fun guy. So we're super excited.
Yeah, no, it's exciting. And you'll have three instructors by then, won't you? So
yeah.
You're catching up. You're catching up with the
Finally.
UK. So further to the new instructor, Jules. I know there's been a lady called Vundermar, who recently did a Peloton commercial. Maybe you can tell us a little bit about the story around that.
Yeah, so Vundermom, aka Barbara, she was featured in the newest, I think it was the US Peloton advert, which again kind of speaks about how important Germany is for them to, I mean, they've included, I think it was three people, one of them being obviously Barbara. I don't want to take away from her story because I think it's something super special. I mean, her son obviously uses the Peloton bike, and you can get a bit of that just in the advert. But yeah, she's a very active member in the German Ladies, and we were so excited to see, like, she kept it super quiet. Like, we had no idea she was going to be in that advert until it aired. And then she was finally like, oh my God, I can finally tell you, because she did have a different leaderboard name before. And it was like, we had no idea why it was like changing. And then suddenly the advert was out, and we were just all so excited because if any of us German ladies deserved it, I think she's one of them. Like, she's so active and has like a beautiful story of like how the bike fits into her life. And yeah, so
sure.
Cool.
So she kept it a secret. You didn't know anything about it?
Nothing. No, we had no idea.
So you saw the advert and then thought, oh, I know that lady.
And she announced the advert to us because I think it was only aired in the US. We didn't actually get to see it, but we were the first ones to know when it was finally cleared that, you know, she was allowed to share the ad. And it was, yeah.
Fantastic. That's a great story, isn't it? And maybe we should have her on as a guest on a future Pillow Chat.
You totally should. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. So what else have you got coming up in the German Ladies community, Jules? What have you got exciting coming up?
So much. So obviously, I think the most obvious one is next week's Halloween. There's obviously quite a few Halloween rides on the schedule, but we're organizing another, I'd say Oktoberfest style, like obviously a dress up fancy theme kind of Halloween group ride together. So that's coming up. So we will be on the Jess King Halloween ride live. So if you do see some German hashtags flying around, please high five us. We will probably be drinking lots of water. That's pretty useful.
And then is it water? Is it definitely water?
Yes. Because that's what Germans are famous for.
Of course. Yeah.
And then I think what's exciting as well is so Peloton, I think, months ago announced a partnership with Deutsche Fußballbund, which is the German football union. So
Of
the German national team. So initially there wasn't quite much information about like what this would entail. Like, we thought we knew a couple of footballers already on the leaderboard. But it seems like they are adding now special themed football rides. So we did find on the schedule some DFB rides hosted by Eric and Irene. So we're quite interested to see what this entails.
Very.
There were some rumors about like a more structured program around that. So yeah, stay tuned. Wow. I guess.
Well, that is very interesting. Well, that's brilliant. Thanks, Jules, for that update. And okay, Jules, so this is now the time in the show, Pelo Chat, where we do something called the 60-second descent and recovery. Sure, you know all about this because you've watched all our episodes before. And I'm going to ask you, I'm going to fire some questions at you over a 60-second period. So are you up for that, Jules?
Let's do it.
Brilliant. Okay. So let's start. Favorite instructor?
Irene.
Oh, that's quick. High cadence or high resistance?
High resistance, always.
Okay. Jules, are you an early bird rider or do you like to ride late at night? Are you a night owl?
Definitely a night owl.
Okay. Meditation or strength training?
Strength training all the way for me.
Okay. Live or on-demand rides, what do you prefer?
Live.
Okay. And do you remember your first class that you ever took?
Yeah, it was a 30-minute hip-hop ride with Alex Toussaint.
Wow, 30-minute one as well. That's brave for your first ride. And favorite ever class? Do you have one?
One of the metal rides. I'd say one of Eric's or Kendall's metal rides because it's my music.
Brilliant. You're into your heavy metal, yeah?
Yeah.
Brilliant. Well, that's it. We've run out of time. Well done, Jules. That was did very well. And listen, one of the questions we have to ask at the end of Pelo Chats is, it's an important question. What is your leaderboard name?
It's Jules_Katharina.
Okay. So you are aware now. You're going to get lots of high fives and people are going to be looking out for you, Jules, going forward.
No pressure.
And listen, you were brilliant on the chat. And what we'd like to do, if you're up for it, is because we're featuring the German community, as you mentioned earlier, a lot more. Would you be prepared to come on from time to time and update us on the on what's happening in Germany, in the Peloton community out there?
Absolutely. Call me anytime.
Brilliant. Yeah, we will do. That's for sure. Listen, it's been a pleasure talking to you, Jules. Thanks for spending time on a very busy day. I know you're a busy lady. And yeah, thanks very much. And it's been a real pleasure.
Thank you so much for having me.
Thanks, Jules.
It's time to celebrate our fans' milestones with Pelo Shouts.
Steve OJ, happy 450 today. Craig Lennon, happy 400.
Amelia Bedelia, whoa, throwback. 600.
Dorset John, 300. Chaos, 250. 250, here I come. I see you there. Happy 250.
Also nochmal ganz kurz an unsere German Ladies. Schön, dass ihr mit dabei seid. Eure High Fives sind natürlich nicht in Gang, beziehungsweise eure Milestones sind mir nicht in Gang. Die Barbara mit ihren 400 Rides. Die Claudia mit ihren 500. Die Ina mit ihren 250. Und haben wir noch jemand mit dabei gehabt? Warte. Will jetzt hier nicht, weil mir wurde schon angekündigt, ich darf auf keinen Fall verzocken.
Heather G 500. Zen AF 550.
Dog Ops. 650 to let me miss you in the studio, babe.
Zeta 426, happy 450 today.
Ha! Das waren die vier. Und dann haben wir Kelly Craig mit 900 Rides. Mega Leistung. Krasse Sache.
Segler 3, happy 900 Rides to you today. You absolutely wonderful human.
Did you hit a milestone this week and get a shout out by your favorite instructor? Don't forget to let us know.
Another jam-packed week, Mark. It's just crazy with so much information. I think for me, I wouldn't say the highlight, but I think the bit of news or segment that comes out to me is definitely the delivery issues. And I'm just praying that things kind of move back to normal as quickly as possible. For those folks watching, if you have not received your bike yet or listening and you're anxious to get it, it's worth the wait. So let's hope that things pick up quickly and you guys will get your bike soon. But that for me, I think was definitely something that I'm the most, anxious about, seeing what happens.
Yeah, and I love my Pelo chat with Jules Katharina. And yeah, she did an amazing chat. Very smart lady, came across really, really well. And it was interesting to hear about the German community and how it's growing. And yeah, really, 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 really enjoyed it. And yeah, for all our listeners and all our viewers, if you'd like to leave a review of what you think of our show, then we'd be so happy to read what you have to say. Anything you want to say, any positives, any negatives, anything you would like to give us, we'd love to hear it. So yeah, it's been a brilliant episode, and yeah, thanks for watching.
Yeah,
bye-bye everybody.
Bye-bye everybody, see you soon.
Thank you for watching Pelo Buddy TV, your unofficial resource for everything Peloton, by the community, for the community. Don't forget that we have a podcast available so that you can listen to us while on the move. Just search for Pelo Buddy TV on any major platform and hit the subscribe button to never miss an episode.